Hi everyone, welcome to the CA classroom. Today we will be covering a concept called bonus issue. Bonus issue has three buckets. One, to understand the concept of what is a bonus issue, why a company issues bonus shares. Second, what are the provisions regarding bonus issue. And third, how do I account for a bonus issue. Exam, you get problems majorly only from how to account a bonus issue. First, let's look at the concept of what is a bonus issue. Bonus issue means issue of free additional shares to existing shareholders. Let's take a company X Limited and let's say you have 100 shares in this company. Now, if they are going to issue bonus shares in the ratio of 1 for every 10 shares, you will receive 10 free shares, which will make you shareholder of total 110 shares of the company. Will the company receive anything? No. Company will not receive any cash inflows. Now let us understand, why will a company go for a bonus issue? Let this be balance sheet of X Limited. Let's say the share capital is 200, reserves and surplus is 500. Other liabilities are 300, total comes to 1000, fixed assets is 700, current assets is 300, total comes to 1000. Looking at this balance sheet, the first thing that would strike to you is, company has heavy reserves and surplus. That means they have been earning profits for the past few years, but they have not distributed the profits to the shareholders. Looking at the asset side, most of the earnings are saved and used in purchasing fixed assets. Current assets is reasonable amount. Now, if the company wants to declare dividend by giving this reserves to the shareholders, they would require equivalent amount of liquid cash. In case where a company does not have enough liquid cash, or company feels it wants to convert its heavy reserves to share capital. Reason number one, low liquidity. Two, if they want to increase the number of shares available for trading in the market, they might issue bonus shares. No. After issuing bonus shares, let's say you had 100 shares before bonus issue. After bonus issue, you have 110 shares. What will happen to the value of your share, market price of a share? Now, how is market price of a share computed? Value of the company divided by number of shares. When a company issues bonus shares, value of a company will remain the same because there is no inflow of cash. So value, market value will remain the same. However, number of shares is increasing. Numerator being the same, denominator increasing, value per share will theoretically fall. This is the concept of bonus issue. How a bonus issue works, why a company goes for a bonus issue. Next, we will look at the provisions which govern the bonus issue. In the previous section, we had discussed the concept of bonus issue. One of the most important concepts is, students might feel after issuing free shares, company share price will increase, but theoretically share price will fall. We had seen the reason for the same. Now coming to the provisions. We have SEBI regulations, regulation 92 to 95 of SEBI, which governs bonus issue. We also have section 63 of the Companies Act 2013. Section 63 is pretty simple. It says what all approvals you require, what are the conditions for issuing bonus issue. We will see that in detail when we come to Companies Act. In SEBI regulations, There are four provisions, 92, 93, 94 and 95. Now, all the companies going for bonus issue should comply with section 63. However, SEBI regulations are applicable only for a listed company. What is regulation 92? It is similar to section 63 of the Companies Act. Regulation 93 talks about certain reservations to issue bonus shares. Section 94 talks about certain restrictions to issue bonus shares. Section 94, Regulation 95 talks about time limit for issuing bonus shares. These are small concepts. Let me explain them. Regulation 93 says, let's take a small example where the company in 2015 has issued convertible debentures or ESOPs which will become equity shares in the year 2021. So remember, in 2015, company has issued convertible debentures or ESOP which will become equity shares in the year 2021. Now, company is issuing bonus shares in the year 2020 to its existing shareholders. Are these people my existing shareholders? No. So, what SEBI regulation says is, where a company has potential security holders, any investors whose securities in the future in 2021 will be converted to equity shares, then such bonus issue should be reserved for those security holders. Meaning, if these conversions are taken place in 2020, even these stakeholders would have received some bonus shares. Reserve bonus shares for them now and issue bonus shares to them when the securities like convertible debentures or ESOP will be converted to equity shares. This is Regulation 93. Regulation 94 says, covers two restrictions. Restriction number one, it says company can use reserves and surplus for issuing bonus shares. However, such reserves and surplus will not include revaluation reserve. Restriction number two, important for exam, questions have come from this area in the past. It says company can use securities premium only if the same is received in cash. So it is very important to note, if a company has securities premium, let's say of 5 lakhs, out of which if 2 lakhs is received in cash and 3 lakh is received in kind, a company which is listed can use only 2 lakhs for the purpose of issuing bonus shares. However, an unlisted company can use the entire amount of 5 lakhs. Last regulation, time limits, very simple. It says bonus issue should be completed within 15 days in case only board approval is required. The same should be completed in 60 days in case shareholders approval is required. That's all. So these are the provisions which govern the bonus issue. Now let us move into how to account for a bonus issue. In the previous section, we had discussed what is the concept of bonus issue, what are the provisions governing a bonus issue. Now we will see how to account for a bonus issue. This is important for your exam. Now, already you are aware that in a bonus issue, reserves and surplus of a company is converted to the share capital of the company. So if reserves have to be converted to share capital, my reserves will decrease, my share capital will increase. So what is the entry I have to pass? Reserves and surplus account decreasing my reserves, therefore debit the reserves, increasing my shares, therefore credit the equity share capital. This is the overall entry. However, this entry will undergo a small change because of the concept I am going to explain. First, when I say reserves and surplus, can I use all the reserves? No. Section 63 says you can use only 3 reserves. First is free reserves. Second is securities premium. Third is capital redemption reserve. Only these 3 reserves can be used for issuing bonus shares. Therefore, instead of debiting reserves and surplus, you will either debit free reserves, general reserve, securities premium, or CRR, or a combination of these 3 to match the amount required. Now, how do I break this entry? Remember, bonus issue will not get over in one day. It takes a few weeks. So let's say bonus issue is announced on 1st of February and allotment takes place on 1st of March. No. Share capital will increase only on 1st of March. Therefore, I can credit equity share capital only on 1st of March. However, company has a liability to issue bonus shares. Therefore, I will debit my reserves and surplus account on 1st of February. This is my net entry, but I will route it through another account because of time gap due to procedure issues. Who is going to receive bonus? My existing shareholders. Therefore, I am going to give my reserves to whom? To bonus, to shareholders, creating a liability towards my existing shareholders and settling that liability on 1st of March. Net impact, this account gets closed. Reserves and surplus account debit to equity share capital will be my net impact. When you write an exam, do not write reserves and surplus account debit. Replace it with free reserves, general reserve account debit, securities premium account debit, CRR account debit to the extent amount allocated. Clear guys? No. One last concept is bonus issue cannot be issued to partly paid up shares unless partly paid up shares are made fully paid up. How do you convert partly paid up to fully paid up? Same entries, reserves and surplus. Instead of bonus to shareholders, I will convert my partly paid up shares to fully paid up shares. So you need to keep in mind two important things for exam. One is check if your shares are fully paid up or partly paid up. Second, when it comes to using of reserves, if the question says company is a listed company, please check if securities premium is received in cash or not. And lastly, you cannot use revaluation reserve. Ignore it in the question. Thank you.